Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the Israel Brief, brought to you by Lay of the Land. Happy Easter, Chag Pesach Sameach. I'm Raleen Marks, your host, and I'll be bringing you today's top stories. And we start off in Poland, where we have insights and reports coming out about what it was like to celebrate the first Pesach Seder since World War II. And this is quite extraordinary. You know, the first night of Pesach or Passover coincided with the anniversary of the Warsaw Ghetto Uprising. So since this time, there has been no formal Pesach Seder where the community has gathered to commemorate and to mark this very, very sacred occasion. So under the auspices of the Chabad rabbi and given in both Polish and Hebrew, many came from around Poland and in fact around the world to what is now the outskirts of the former Warsaw Ghetto. Many residents of the city put up yellow flowers made out of paper to commemorate the Warsaw Ghetto Uprising. And what is quite extraordinary is that here in Israel, families gather, big families, to celebrate the Passover, the Pesach Seder together. But for many of those who celebrated in Warsaw, their families are very small. They lost most of their families during the war. Some people have only recently discovered that they are Jewish. And it was a very, very moving and very, very emotional Lila Seder or Seder evening, and projected onto a very, very modern glass building just outside, and in fact on the outskirts of what was the Warsaw Ghetto, was a light show of the former Great Synagogue in Warsaw. And it's extremely heartwarming to see this resurgence of Jewish life after nearly two-thirds of Jewry in Europe were wiped out in the Holocaust in the Second World War. But staying in Poland, and this time with not such a positive story, the Catholic Church has come out in condemnation of an anti-Semitic effigy burning that took place on the weekend. To celebrate Easter, residents of the southeast Polish town of Prochnik, both adults and children, beat and burnt an effigy of what was supposed to represent Judas, the disciple of Christ who is said to have betrayed him. Now, this effigy looked more like a modern-day Orthodox Jew with the peyot, dressed in black and white, and with the horrible anti-Semitic stereotypic trope of having a big nose. And the Catholic Church has come out and said that manifestations of anti-Semitism of this sort will not be tolerated by the Catholic Church. And sadly, staying with issues of anti-Semitism, this time yet again from the UK Labour Party and Labour MP Graham Morris has taken a lot of criticism online for tweeting about an incident he thought were IDF soldiers beating a Palestinian child. It turns out that this film footage was Guatemalan soldiers beating Guatemalan children in 2015. And thousands of people have criticized him and asked for him, A, to apologize and also to remove the tweet immediately. He has apologized, but we haven't heard whether or not he has removed the offensive tweet. He prefaced his tweet with magnificent, truly magnificent. The most well-funded, most highly trained, most powerful army in the world, you know, has to beat up on small children. And the IDF responded with what is only magnificent. Or the only thing that is magnificent about this is the fact that this is so untrue, and giving the truth about what the video was supposed to contain. So it is a reminder to people out there that always check your news sources, always check your facts before you post something that could be extremely inflammatory, extremely offensive, not to mention untrue. And we're staying in the region, and this time, Hizbollah is on the wanted list by the United States. The United States have put a reward or a $10 million bounty out there for any information that anybody has that could explain or has information as to how Hezbollah's financial networks are being used. The United States is highly concerned about Hezbollah and the influence in the region and abroad. If we remember back, Hezbollah operatives were responsible for the bombing of the AMIA building in Buenos Aires, Argentina, some years ago, which claimed the lives of many Jews. And this shows just how far the tentacles of this organization that's recognized by the U.S., Britain and many other countries as a terror organization reaches. Hezbollah, along with Hamas, are Iranian-funded proxies, but this time the U.S. have raised the bounty to $10 million. So if you out there have any information about how Hezbollah's financial networks run, it would be in your best interest to contact the U.S. State Department. So these are your top stories for today. I'm Rolene Marks with the Israel Brief, and we'll chat again tomorrow. But don't forget, you can still read our content online at www.layoftheland.online. Today you can read an article by Rowan Pollivan of the South African Cape Council on just what South Africa is getting wrong with their foreign policy. Also, join our ever-growing family on Facebook by liking us or following us at Lotl Site. You can't miss us. We look a little something like this. And remember that you can subscribe to get your daily editions of the Israel Brief by clicking on the subscribe button below. Chag Sameach, Happy Easter.